Oh, yes. My life has changed completely since Buena Vista Social Club, says Eliades Ochoa. He's a stocky man with rings on his fingers and graying hair with a heavy face. And when we talked, it had already been a couple of years since the album and film took him from folkloric singer to international star with his black hat and guitar singing Chan Chan, Píntate los labios, María, the song they made into an animated video that was seen everywhere. Life-changing years, and now people recognized Eliades in Europe and even in Japan. Now, even in Cuba, kids follow me down the street singing Píntate los labios. Eliades is amused, but uncomfortable too. I'm not used to all this attention. I'm just a simple musician, guajiro sin mayores complicaciones, who just likes to play and sing for people. No, no me acostumbro a esto, seguro que no. It's the hat, I tell him. Debe ser el sombrero. Bueno, que I know, but I can't go out without my hat, without it. I'm not myself, no soy yo. I don't even recognize myself without mi sombrero tejano. Fame has brought Eliades many things. Con oro todo es posible, he jokes, but it didn't buy what he wanted most, the recognition he never got from Compay Segundo, who's dead now. Compay, the best singer and songwriter, Eliades says, the one he rescued from obscurity in the 1980s, long before Ry Cooder found him. But Compay never spoke of this. One of Eliades' many efforts to preserve and rejuvenate his traditional Cuban music, it was his life's mission. And that still hurts. Eliades frowns. He doesn't want to talk about the Buena Vista Social Club. It wasn't Ry Cooder who discovered Compay, not Columbus who discovered the New World. It was Eliades who brought him back, all from a love for his country's music. So even at the height of his fame, when Cuban musicians traveled the U.S. freely, Eliades never moved to Spain or the U.S. He never chose gold over culture. Eliades always knew who he was. I never went to any kind of school, he says. One of seven children of farmers who moved to Santiago, where Eliades started playing on the streets for pennies. Playing for pennies until the revolution changed everything. He came of age in a world where culture and music were honored. I was given a radio show, a salary, clothing, food coupons, he remembers. For the first time, I felt like I was worth something. He didn't tell that to me, though, when I asked him about the revolution. Instead, he told a Mexican journalist in Mexico. It's always wise to be careful, Eliades learned, living in Cuba. He didn't need a school to teach him that or how to play the guitar. I opened my eyes, he says, and there was la guaracha, el son, la guajira, el changui, the music of my parents, and that was all the music I ever needed. The Lion of Santiago, they called him in those days of struggle to revive his country's traditional music when others of his generation turned their ears to the power of the North. I recognized the torrent of life that ran through it, he says. Un manantial, a wellspring, an inexhaustible mine. And down Eliades went to rescue it from the dustbin of history, he says. Si fue al cajón del olvido. Shook the dust off and polished them up, he says. And then those songs won a Grammy for Raikouter in America, where the money resides. But Eliades never defected, though others did. Baseball stars and musicians like Arturo Sandoval, with big homes in Orlando near Tiger and Shaq, playing their music at Disney World. No, Eliades stayed, but it was not a political decision. No somos políticos, he says. We aren't politicians. We are musicians who play for the people. We are flesh and blood. We belong to the human race. I don't carry a rifle. I carry a guitar. And I'm not going to make a speech. I'm going to sing un bolero de amor. And so, singing of love, Eliades traveled the world, but he always returned to sit on his porch, to talk to his neighbors. The revolution was made for people like Eliades, marked by the rhythms of their city, by the light that falls across the fields in the late afternoon, marked by the beat of sown music, born in Santiago, where Eliades played and sang on the streets for pennies before the revolution that changed his life more profoundly than the fame of Pinta de los Labios, more profoundly than Chan Chan ever could. It's why he stayed. I don't carry a rifle, he says. I carry a guitar, and I'm going to sing un bolero de amor.